children, how are you? Oh, I am really great. I'm doing fine. What about you all? Are you all safe? Very good. Now you all are wondering who I am, isn't it? So before we start, I would like to introduce myself. Okay, so my name is Suma and I would be teaching you mathematics. Can we set the journey for mathematics together? Can we have a lot of fun activities together? Wonderful. So if you are all ready, can you just raise your hands? Raise your hands. Can we clap together? 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Very good. Everyone is ready. I can see everyone sitting, like ready with your notebook and textbook. Wonderful. Now, before we start anything, I'm going to ask a small question to you. It's not related to mathematics. Let me see. It's a riddle. Are you ready for the riddle? So wait and watch. The question will come on your screen. Okay, so let's see. So can we see what the question is? Here comes the question for you. The more there is, the less you can see. What am I? The more there is, the less you can see. What am I? Can you answer to this question? Come on, think for it. Do you know the answer? No? Oh, you want me to tell the answer? Once again, let me read out the question for you. The more there is, the less you can see. What is that? What am I? No, no one is able to give a guess. Oh, it's okay. Next time, be prepared for such questions. Okay, so let me give the answer for this question. Here comes the answer. Oh, what is this? Is this the answer towards the question? Now, can you try to relate the question? The more there is, less you can see. What am I? It's the darkness. If it's dark, will you be able to see? That the more darkness, the less you will be able to see, isn't it? Okay, now since the riddle time is over, can we move and see how numbers are formed? Do you know how numbers are formed? Have you seen? Have you experienced how numbers are formed? So we will try to recollect how numbers are formed. All right. So I am going to take some base 10 blocks for you so that you are able to understand it better. Now, can you see on the screen? Can you see a small block? This is known as ones block. Can you see here? We have this is a tens block. And how does it become 10? Because there are 10 ones. If you count it, if I am counting this, you can understand. We will have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 ones will make, sorry, 10 ones will make 110. So this is known as tens block. This is known as tens block. Okay. And now what is this known as? This is known as hundreds block. This is known as hundreds block because we will have 100 ones here. And how many tens will make 100? Come on, tell me. How many tens will make 100? Oh, someone is giving me the answer. Is that Aisha who is giving the answer? Very good, Aisha. The answer is absolutely correct. 10 makes 10 will make 100. Similarly, 10 hundreds will make 1,000. So let's see how the numbers are formed. Okay, so this is a thousands block. Now I would be keeping the blocks and you will read out the number for me. Okay, let's see. How many thousands block did I take? I took 2,000 block. And how many hundreds block did I take? I have taken 300s block. And now I'm taking tens block. Now let's see how many tens. Now tell me, how many tens do you want? Okay, someone gave me the answer 5. So I'm taking 5 tens. And I would be taking 3 ones. Now you have to tell me what the number is. What is the number? Since we have 2 thousands, we will be writing 2 in the thousands place. We will be writing 2 in the thousands place. And where will we write? How many hundreds do we have? We have 300. So we will be writing 3 in the hundreds place. And how many tens do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 tens, which is equal to 50. Can you see there are 50 small blocks? Okay. So that it is equal to 50. 5 tens is equal to 50. 3 hundreds is equal to 300. 300. And how many ones are there? We have 3 ones. So what would be the number? The number would be, can we read the number together? 2,353. 2,000. Why did we say 2,000? Because we have 2,000s block. So 2,353. Why do we say 50? Because we have 5 tens, which is equal to 50. If there are 6 tens, we will say it as 60. If there are 7 tens, we will say 70. Why are we saying 70? Because in 1 ten, we will have tens block, we will have 10 ones. So if there are 5 tens block, that means we have 50 ones. Very good. So the number is 2,353. Very good. I think you all are very smart. So we saw the number, it is 2,353. See, I have written the number name. How do you write your name? You spell it out, isn't it? So the same way for a number, when we are writing the spelling, it becomes the number name. So can we just try to read this number? Can someone read this number for me? Come on. Yes, everyone read this number. 3,000, because 3 is in thousands place. 3,562. So the way you read, you will have to write the number name in the same way. So let us try to write the number name in the same way. 3,562. 3,562. Now can someone read this number? 1,000. In the hundreds place, you see a zero. So will we say 0,100? No, we will not say 0,100. So we will read this number as, we will just skip the hundreds place because it is zero. It doesn't have any value, isn't it? Okay. So 1,056. 1,056. Can everyone read it aloud? 1,056. Okay. Now can everyone read the next number? Can everyone read the next number? We do not have anything in the hundreds place and tens place. Okay, so we will just read it as 9,005, because we have 5 in the ones place. So can we all read this number once again? 3,562. 3,562. 1,056. If we are writing the number like this, 1056, we will read it as 1056. And then I have written another number, which is 9005. Will we read the number like that? No, we will read the number as 9005. Did you understand? Is it clear to you? Very good. Now we will see if the number name is given, how to write it in the standard form. So can I give you an example for it? Okay. See, 6050. 6050. So how do we write this number? We will write 6 in the thousands place. We will write 6 in the thousands place. And then since we do not have anything in the hundreds place, we will write it as 0. So here comes the number 6050, 6050. We do not have anything in the hundreds place and we do not have anything in the ones place. So the number becomes 6050. When we are writing in the numerical form, it is known as the standard form. When we are writing in the numerical form, it is known as the standard form. So can we see another example now? Okay. Now here it comes. 7000. So that means 7 is in the thousands place. 800. So 8 is in the hundreds place. And do we see anything in the tens place? No. And then directly it says 9. So 9 will be in the ones place. So here comes the number 7809. So there is no tens in it. That's all. Okay, so we will write 0 in the tens place. Now can we see one more example so that I can understand whether you are able to follow it or not? Okay, now this time you will have to give me the answer. I'm not going to give you the answer. Okay. So here comes the question, 5625. So 5000. So 5 comes in which place? Thousands place. And how many hundreds? 600. So 6 is coming in the hundreds place. And then we say 25. How do we write 25? 2, 5 is 25. So here comes the number. Absolutely correct. You all are correct. So the number is 5625. So when we are writing any number in numerical form, see this? So it will be known as the standard form. So if someone is giving you the number name, will you be able to write the number for it? Yes, it's all there in your textbook. So do such similar questions. Okay. Now, we will also see how to write a number in the expanded form. Expanded means we are elaborating the number along with the place value of each digit. So, let's see with an example, okay? So, how do we read this number? 5783. So, 5 is in the thousands place. So, what will be the value? We have 5000s. So 1000, 2000, 3000, 4000, 5000. So how will we write 5000? 5 followed by 3 zeros. Very good. So the value here would be 5000 plus 7 is in which place? It is in hundreds place. So what will be the value? 700. 8 is in which place? Tens place. Very good. So we will write it as 80 plus 3. 3 is in the ones place. So we will have to only write 3. Okay. So when we are writing in this form, this is known as expanded form. So 5783, when it is expanded, we will write it as 5000 plus 700 plus 80 plus 3. Can we see one more example? Okay. 9503. Now, can you see here in tens place it is 0? So, since we are reading this number as 9503, so we have 9000. So, what will be the value? It will be 9000 plus 5 is in hundreds place, so it will be plus 500. Do we have anything in the tens place? So, we need not mention it, and we can directly write plus 3. So when we are writing in expanded form 9503, we will write it as 9000 plus 500 plus 3. Okay, can we see one more example? Very good. 8025. 8 is in which place? Thousands place. Do we have anything in hundreds place? No, someone said we can leave that. Very good. And then since we have 2 in the tens place, we will write it as plus 20. And then 5 is in the ones place, so we can write it as plus 5. So 8025, when we are expanding, we will get 8000 plus 20 plus 5. Very good. So what all we have learned? We know how to read and write 4-digit numbers. We know how to write in the standard form. We know how to write it in the expanded form. We also know how to write the number name of a given number. Do you all know? Very good. Now, I have 4 numbers with you. See, can you see there are 4 numbers with me? Yes? Can you see that? Okay. Now, you have to tell me. Okay? You have to tell me how can we form the smallest 4-digit number? How can we form the smallest 4-digit number? Think for a minute. Come on. So what are we supposed to do? We are supposed to make the smallest 4-digit number. But then we know that the smallest 4-digit number is 1000. But in this case, we have to use these numbers. We have to use the given numbers to make the smallest 4-digit number. We need the smallest 4-digit number. Okay, to form the smallest 4-digit number, we have to arrange the numbers from, the given numbers has to be arranged from small to big. Now, can you see which number is small? 0 is smaller. But if 0 comes in thousands place, will it become a 4-digit number? No. So, if 0 is coming, we will take the next smallest number, and the next smallest number is 2. So, what will come in thousands place? What will come in thousands place? We will have 2. And the next smallest number, actually the smallest number is 0. But if you put 0 in the hundreds place, it will become a 3-digit number. And we have to form a 4-digit number, isn't it? So, the next number what comes in hundreds place is 0. What is the next biggest number? So we are going from small to big, okay? 0 is a special case. So if 0 is the smallest number, we will not consider that in the thousands place. We will consider it in the hundreds place, because we have to form a 4-digit number and we are not asked to form a 3-digit number. So what is the next biggest number? 5. Very good. And what is the next number? What will come in the ones place then? 9. So the smallest number which we can form by using 5290 is 2059. So can we use the same example and form the greatest 4-digit number? Can we form? Okay. So if we are asked to form the greatest 4-digit number, we will start arranging the numbers from big to small. So what is the first biggest number? What is the biggest number in this? Who can say? 9. Very good. So 9 will come in thousands place. And what will come in the hundreds place? Which is the next biggest number? 5. Very good. And then the number which is smaller than 5 is 2. So we are arranging in the descending order. Can you see? The digits are arranged in the descending order. 9, 5, 2, 0. Descending means from big to small. Big to small. When we do that, then we can get greatest 4-digit numbers. Did you understand how to frame numbers? And what is the rule behind it? Very good. So try doing some questions so that you are understanding it in a better way. Very good. Now, what is this? Ascending order. Now, do you know what ascending order means? Just now I told what ascending order is. From small to big. From small to big. Now, let us try to take an example, okay? We have to arrange these 4 numbers. Can you see there are 4 numbers? We have to arrange these 4 numbers in ascending order. That means we have to arrange from small number to bigger number, smallest to biggest. Now let us see how to compare the numbers. Can we all see that these are all 4-digit numbers? So let us start with the thousands place. So we have to arrange from small to big. So we have to consider first small number. So can you see 6 in the thousands place? Here the second number it is 5, third number it is 6, and fourth number it is 5. So we have 2 digits in the thousands place. What are they? 5 and 6. Out of this 5 and 6, which is the smallest? 5. Okay. So the first number is going to be one of these. Either it should be 5213 or it should be 5231. Now to decide out of these two which number will come, we have to see the hundreds place. Can you see the hundreds place? 2. So both are same. So let's go to the ones place. So here in ones place it is. Sorry, we will go to the tens place. So here in tens place we have 1. And here in tens place we have 3. So 1 or 3, which one is smaller? 1. So what would be the first number? The first number would be 5213. And the next number would be 5231. Now we have to do a comparison of these numbers. See, both have 6 in the thousands place. So can we check the ones place, hundreds place? So in hundreds place here we have 5 and in this number we have 6. Which one is smaller, 5 or 6? 5. So I will write 6523. And the last number would be 6664. Now can you check? Yes. Did we arrange from small number to bigger number? So when we are arranging numbers from smallest to biggest, it is known as ascending order. It is known as ascending order. Now we will see what is descending order. You all have studied this previously. If you don't know, you can look at this picture. What can you see? You can see ducks which are bigger and then it goes smaller, 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 smaller and smaller. So from big to small. Okay, from big to small. So when we arrange numbers from largest to smallest, we say that it is arranged in descending order. big to small is descending order. Small to big is ascending order. So what are we doing now? We are doing descending order. So can we take an example? Very good. See, can you see there are four numbers? So which one is the greatest? Tell me. Okay, we have two numbers in which 8 is there in the thousands place, and the other two numbers we have 7 in the thousands place. So which is greater? So the number which has 8 in the thousands place would be greater than the others. Yes or no in this example? Then we have to see the hundreds place. See the hundreds place. What is there in the hundreds place? 6. And here we have again 6. So we will go and check the tens place. In this number we have 7 in the tens place, and here we have 4 in the tens place. So which one will come? 8674 is the biggest number. The next biggest number is 8647. And out of these two numbers, 7853 is bigger than 7823. So can you see? We have arranged from big to small. Bigger number to smaller number. So that is known as descending order. Okay. I hope you all have enjoyed the class. You have all understood. So let us just try to recollect what all we have seen today. What all did we see today? Come on, tell me, what all did we see? Or what all have we learned today? We have learned how to read and write four-digit numbers. We have learned how to write the number name. We know how to write the expanded form. Now we can also write numbers in the standard form. Yes, we have seen how to make the smallest four-digit and greatest four-digit number using any given four numbers. We have seen that. We have also seen how to arrange numbers in ascending order. Ascending order means small to big. Descending means big to small. So we have seen all these things today, and I request everyone to go ahead and practice at home. Now before we wind up, there is a small surprise for you. And this is the surprise. Okay. Can you see there is a puzzle what I have given? And what is this puzzle? You have to fill up numbers. See, put the numbers from 1 to 7. So in these circles, you have to place numbers from 1 to 7. And there is a condition for it. What is the condition? In the circles, in such a way that when you add up, it should be 7. So that is the 7-up challenge for you. Are you ready to do the 7-up challenge? So when you are putting the numbers in the straight line, when you are adding, it should be 7. Not only the straight line. How many straight lines can we see? 1, 2, 3 straight lines we can see. So in all the 3 straight lines, the sum should be, sum means when you are adding, okay, the sum should be 7 up. So there is a challenge, 7 up challenge for you. Okay. So can you take up this challenge? Yes. Very good. So all of you have to do this challenge and show it to me in the next class. Okay. So bye bye. See you in the next class, children. Let's wait. And you have to practice all the concepts what we have learned today. See you in the next class.